The Russian proposal just may avert a U.S. military strike on Syria, but Israel is continuing to beef up its defenses in case of a retaliatory attack. CBN Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell has that story.
Russia's foreign minister made the proposal, and Syria quickly welcomed the idea for the international community to collect and destroy Syria's chemical weapons.
Syria welcomes the Russian proposal out of concern for the lives of the Syrian people, the security of our country, and because it believes in the wisdom of the Russian leadership that seeks to avert American aggression against our people.
Washington is skeptical of the Russian-Syrian proposal and says Congress should vote to keep the pressure on Syrian President Assad.
It's clear that this proposal comes in the context of the threat of U.S. action and the pressure that the president is exerting. So it's even more important that we don't take the pressure off and that Congress give the president the authority he's requested.
The Senate decided to delay its vote so it could consider Russia's proposal. In the meantime, Israel has distanced itself from the Syrian civil war and the U.S. buildup, but they could face retaliatory attacks from Syria in case of a U.S. military strike. So the government is taking no chances.
We're in the hills on the outskirts of Jerusalem, and behind me is the Iron Dome anti-missile battery system. This marks the first time the Israeli army has ever deployed an active missile defense system in the Jerusalem area.
Israeli Defense Minister Moshe Ya'alon said earlier that Israel is ready to deal with the consequences of a U.S. military strike on Syria. Israelis are still lining up for gas masks, and for now, the world is waiting to see who will make the next move. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, The Hills of Jerusalem.